Hi, everybody. Welcome to Movie Talks with Michael, the movie talk show where I, Michael, speak with some of my friends. And the guest on the show is the wonderful and talented Catie Wayne, who you might be familiar with from A New Hope, her own channel, or perhaps Animalist, or even Boxy.
Oh.
Catie, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me, Michael.
When we were actually talking about you being on the show, you were like, I have a rather unconventional favorite as far as the Pirates films go, and your favorite of the original trilogy is
Three.
At World's End.
So I just want to say right at the top of this discussion, I know that it is objectively bad. I know there's so much wrong with it, and there's like a lot of contrivances. By golly, it's such a swell time. I just have such a good time watching it.
Why? Let's dive into just...
Okay. For one thing, our baddie, our big bad villain.
Mm-hmm.
Good Lord, what was his name?
Davy Jones.
No, the other one.
Oh, Lord Beckett.
Yes. What a delight that guy is. He's such a, he's so fun. I just, I really enjoy villains like that. I mean, like, and I think that Davy Jones is a wonderful, like side villain, but also, like, misunderstood. He's wonderful as well. And in the first one,
Barbossa.
Yes, Barbossa was a wonderful villain.
Right.
And they're, but they, you know, rawr and pirates and rah. And this guy's just, wait, am I allowed to say bad words?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. and this guy is like, he's just like a swag for days. He's just so fucking sophisticated. He's like, I don't got time for your swords and treachery. It's tea time, motherfucker.
Yeah, there's like, definitely several points in the movie
he's
where
just like tea.
there's a scene, I believe it's in three, it might actually be in two, but those two movies kind of blend together.
Yeah.
Where Will is sent to Beckett with the compass to more or less like help them find Captain Jack Sparrow. And both of them are just being so bitchy and drinking tea while Davy Jones
it's
is
like having a tantrum.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
They just have the just, oh, really?
Yeah, I know. And then Davy Jones has a little bitch fit and knocks Will's tea out of his hand. And Will's like, I didn't finish with that. It's so dumb. But it's so fun.
It's a fun movie, like, but as far as, I mean, when you think about Jerry Bruckheimer type films,
okay.
I will give you, and you had mentioned this before we started recording, that you are a big fan of the climax near the end. But before we jump in on that, I'd say the climax is really the only like big monumental like action part that really stands out, where if you look to Dead Man's Chest, you've got the fun bit in the bone cages running away from the tribal like the cannibals, and then later you've got that fun set piece of them all chasing after the chest and the key, and then they're on the wagon wheel, and it just has this, as far as swashbuckling fun goes, I feel two is the one that feels more like swashbuckling, and this one feels more like double cross on double cross on double cross.
Maybe that it's fun for me. I actually really disliked the whole cannibal portion.
I wouldn't say that it's like, it feels almost Temple of Doom a little bit.
Yeah, it's a little unnecessary. Like, I mean, I don't know, but I mean, this whole movie franchise was unnecessary. But like,
oh, now those are fighting words. I know, but they managed to do it pretty well as far as, like, adaptation goes. Really? I mean, if you want to talk about bad adaptation, it would be Haunted Mansion with Eddie Murphy.
Oh, Haunted Mansion was first, right?
No, Haunted Mansion was after.
Oh.
Yeah, they made...
Okay.
They made Pirates, and then they were like, this works.
Yeah, okay.
Let's push something up. knocked over your Zowers. Sorry.
That's how rude of you.
Now we're both like snacking. One thing that regarding those double crosses, mm-hmm. I think it almost makes the characters too... Everybody in the first film mm-hmm. is very much one or the other. I'm good, I'm bad. And Captain Jack Sparrow just like is a chaotic neutral.
Is he or isn't he? By the knows, end but of, he sure is cute.
By the end of the third film, everybody's just in that super gray, what are your motives? So a lot of things that are going on become really confusing until they have to overtly say, and then it just becomes so plotty.
But isn't it a good thing because that they make them a little bit grayer? Because by the end of the movie, by the end of the third movie, they're celebrating having killed so many people. And it's like, these are our protagonists. Like, we're happy that everyone is dead because those are our antagonists. But
right.
it's like, you know, like in most Disney movies, they always have the bad guy die or like fall off of a cliff. And then the good guy at the last minute is like, oh no, I tried to save them. Because I'm the good guy and I would never actually try to kill someone.
Right.
Like, no, they have to make them a little bit of morally gray like they're pirates. Because otherwise, like, they're saying that wanting to kill large amounts of people is like a good protagonist-y thing, but by the end it's like they're all pirates and
well,
they're Pirates of the Caribbean.
This is the weird one where they're fighting like the corporation of mm-hmm. the East India Trading Company,
yeah,
which is like housed up by Beckett and that whole crew, and their whole angle is they just want the Dutchmen so they can control the seas, yeah. so they can control trade and have a monopoly, which is just like... As far
is
as
is there
like,
anything more evil?
Right. We just want people to have access to our tea.
It's some good fucking tea. That's why we have it all the time.
Wow. Oh. Singapore, like
was
when
you, fun.
But when
was
you first
fun.
But when you first go to Singapore, you're like, oh, this is kind of racist. And then
oh, yeah.
and then
oh, yeah.
the movie steps it up a whole notch of like, oh, you thought that was racist. No. We've got a whole like round table of racism and stereotypes.
It's problematic. It's problematic for sure. And it's not okay, but they got some cool flags. So
that's the thing we can let it go by on that regard.
No, it's awful, but oh. God, who is the guy? The big Singapore guy. Oh no.
Chow Yun Fat.
Yes. He is deliciously evil, slimy, you know. There's that whole little thing where like he thinks that Keira Knightley is Calypso. And like coming back around to Keira, I can't stand that character type where it's like the one girl in the whole movie and every guy is like, I want that, give me that. And like every single guy, all of them. And it's like, yes, she's perfectly lovely. Just delightful. Why does everyone want to get in that? Like,
because they're all at sea for so long and they haven't seen it. I mean, when they get to Tortuga, that's their whole game plan.
I know. It's like, okay, like, I know. I know
I'm
that's
certainly
the whole
not
game
defending
plan.
All these pirates.
No.
They're also, like, scurvy-ridden,
yes.
so.
No, definitely. But, like, what I mean is, like, it seems like by the time the third movie comes around, and then, oh, God, that, the guy from the first one, I'm so bad at remembering these characters' names for, like, loving these movies as much as I do. But the guy from the first movie who was going to be engaged to Elizabeth.
Norrington.
Yes. By the time he kisses her in the third one, it's like, she just sort of, like, lets it happen. She's just like, all these guys up on my dick. I don't even care anymore. Like, yeah, I'm engaged to be married, but he wants to kiss me right now, so that's gonna happen. Like she doesn't even care. It's like, she's not even taken aback. She's just like, oh, okay, kiss goodbye before you, okay.
And then
he
gets...
Have fun dying!
Yeah, then he gets stabbed by Will's dad.
I know.
Will's dad is kind of depressing.
Oh my gosh, so
I mean,
sad.
Because by the third film, he's part of the ship, and he has Alzheimer's, kind of. Because mm-hmm, he's got the mm-hmm. whole bit where he just repeats over, and you're like, oh, that's
yeah
real. Oh, if we want to talk dark, though, Elizabeth's dad's sequence.
Ah!
That's a really well-done sequence.
So good.
Like, it...
It's my most favorite thing that Kira does in that movie, when she's like freaking the fuck out.
And she's running down the ship, yep. And they're like, gotta keep her on board.
Take the line! Like, oh God, so sad. Oh.
They did some pretty interesting, like, representational stuff as far as being like, oh, this is how we're
this
representing death.
Yeah, this is the Davy Jones locker. Like, really? Yeah. Really
although I will say that.
Wait. Before I can hear in the tone of your voice, it's about to go downhill. those little rock crabs are adorable, P.S.
Mm-hmm.
Just P.S. They're super cute and I want all of them.
But that whole rock crab sequence is so strange.
It's very bizarre.
It's very, very bizarre. And there's no... I mean, I suppose we're just to understand that Davy Jones' locker is a place of madness and despair. But he gets out of there pretty quick. We don't know how long he's been there.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Who knows how long they were, like, getting lost as Barbossa states, you know?
Right.
We're good and lost. It's like, how long have you been there? When a cute few scenes ago, you were freezing.
Yeah.
Like, you know. But also, Calypso and Davy Jones, that little relationship.
It's a fun one.
It's fun. It's really cool that she's all of a sudden, like, actually important and not just, like, this, like, sassy witch doctor, like, all-knowing thing.
Yeah.
It's like, all of a sudden, there's a reason for her to know everything. And she's like a god, and she's like trapped, but then the love story, and I really love the scene between them when she's in jail, and he's like, you weren't there when I came back, and she's like, it's in my nature, would you love me if I were anything but I am?
Yeah.
Like, it's beautiful.
It's pretty fun that they do speak in such abstractions as far as, like, because she's like a sea goddess personified.
Mm-hmm.
It's this whole thing of like, because it goes back to Gibbs' whole tale of like, I heard that Davy Jones fell in love with the sea. I heard it was a woman. And then it's like, no.
It was both.
Like, you were both right.
Yeah.
Although it's a little, like, I felt her transformation was a little lackluster as far of like, yeah. I grow into a giant and then I turn into crabs.
Yeah, no, that was odd, but... Touching on that note, I really love that the doofus is the one to, like, be like, y'all don't even know how to handle ladies right now. Like, he whispers in her ear, and it's like, ooh, girl. Like, I didn't realize that little one had swagger. Really quick, good moment in two is like the very last sequence when Barbossa comes downstairs.
Oh.
And then it's like Apple and it's just such a good way to be like, oh, Pirates 3.
Yeah, it's a great way to get you stoked on 3 because Barbossa was a favorite of the first. And Jeffrey Rush is stellar. And I do really appreciate how hard they make him play, like, stereotypical
pirate. Yeah, like, oh, it's great though. He's so good. Like, he's so disgusting.
And they've got the one bit when they're both on the Black Pearl and they're calling out commands, and then he goes, what are you doing? And he responds like, what are you doing? What are, like, yeah. Just really lays into it.
No, it's so good.
Those are the playful moments that I really enjoy. I mean, the two of them riffing off one another is wonderful.
Beautiful.
A moment that I'm a big fan of with Keira Knightley is the speech she gives at the end. I think that's, as far as, like, all the flighty, like, I'm going to make out with everyone moments, she really does rally the troops near the end.
Mm-hmm.
Although, then it's just two ships that go to battle, and it gets crazy.
Yeah.
And, like, and then nothing matters, because, like,
yeah.
Yeah,
no, it's weird. It almost, like, when you're watching it, it's the climax is, like, so, it's like, so much is happening, and it's, like, Calypso is free, and, like, then she's, like, the storm, and, like, Davy Jones is, like, back, like, is, and, like, there's so much going on, and then they're, like, up on the mast, and, like, and Jack and Davy are fucking sword fighting.
And then
fighting,
the
and, like,
marriage proposal's happening.
Yes, which is, like, for me, it's, like, a little, like, but...
It's over
but
the
it's
top. Still,
yeah, no, it's real, you know, and fucking Barbossa, just cast, like, fuck.
It's real fun, but then it's like, that all settles, and then they're like, we still have an entire armada to face.
Yeah, yeah, no.
But then,
like, he gets, which he kind of seems like he just sort of walks right into it. Like, they're coming for him, and he's like, why don't we go right in the middle?
Yeah, well, when Will is now the captain of Flying Dutchman, mm-hmm. they've killed Davy Jones, mm-hmm. they surface, and they get on both sides. That's a pretty cool moment when Beckett is just like,
it's just good business.
He's just like, I've lost. Let's just walk through as everything just explodes
that
around me.
That is my most favorite part of the whole thing. That is why that movie, it's my favorite. It's just such a fucking pleasure to see this guy just accept defeat, because it's like, we're fucked and there's nothing we can do about it in this moment. Like,
yeah.
For all of my trickery and tea sessions, I can't do anything about this right now.
Right.
And it's just good business. And he just slowly, like, with his hand on the banister, as it's like, whoop,
yeah, just
like,
hand goes past, it explodes promptly
so
thereafter.
So good. It's so good. He just, like, walks into the flame with, like, this serene look on his face, like, I'm such a badass. Like, I love him. I love it. It's so good.
It closes out really well with Will choosing the life of a pirate.
Yeah.
And choosing to ferry the souls and everything.
Yeah, no, which is great. And then, like, at the end of the credits or whatever, he comes back and, like, it's got a 10-year-old son, and she's there. She didn't leave. So, you know, like, that's sweet and lovely and all of that jazz. Like, it, you know, I get a little bit misty. Although it is weird when he's leaving, and then, like, they touch noses, and then he just leaves.
Yeah,
I'm
he
like,
does the.
You're not gonna see her. Do you know you're not gonna see her for 10 years? You don't want to give her a little kiss goodbye, you piece of shit.
Yeah, he's like, quite the cock tease at the end. He's like, I gotta be on a ship.
Yeah, and and so, but that it's a fun time. Lots of problems, and I know that they're there, but I just have the most fun watching it.
I mean, the Pirates films in general are very fun popcorn movies, and
yeah.
So like. You're always guaranteed, like, at least some degree of enjoyment from them, because they're just goofy and fun.
Yeah.
And on that note, mm-hmm. I would like to thank you for joining me for this movie talk on Pirates at World's End. Fun
no
little discussion.
Worries.
We didn't throw any bows or anything like that, so that was good.
Well, not while the cameras are on.
That's true. If you'd like to be seeing anything more from the lovely Catie Wayne, there will be an annotation right above her head showing all sorts of things there. And if you'd like to be seeing anything more from me, more movie talks, click right above me. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Keep loving movies.
And we'll see you next time.
See you next time.
Mwah. Mwah. Have you ever had these before?
What?
These sours, have you ever had them?
I actually haven't, no.
Do you like watermelon?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
That a girl.
It's good.